My name is NTC7000 or NTC7K.
I just took out your his intro.
Weird challenge.
See that? You jumped.
I can't never forget that. I hate that video so much. What's up, everybody? It's your boy NTC7000 coming to you with another brain teaser video. These questions are coming from riddles.com, and so far they've been pretty good brain teasers. I've failed most of them. So what about you? How have you been doing on them? Have you been passing them, or have you been failing them like me? Because I'm a failure.
Hello, darkness, my old friend.
But yeah, without wasting any of your time, I just want to jump on up into this and get right into it and see maybe if I can actually pass this one. Let's go. I know a word of letters three. I know a word of letters three. Add two and fewer there will be. What is it? Few. That's easy. It's few. You add two letters, it makes fewer. Answer is few. Are these all going to be words? Because this says another word. I don't know. A word I know, six letters it contains. Subtract just one and 12 is what remains. What is the word? I know a word. A word I know, six letters it contains. Subtract just one and 12 is what remains. What is the word? Would it be dozens? Because if you take the S off, then it'll be just dozen, which would be 12. I'm gonna say dozens. It's dozens. Hey. I'm getting all right. Starting off good. 2 for 2. Let's keep going. A horse is tied to a 5-meter rope in front of an old saloon. Saloon? Yeah, saloon. 6 meters behind the horse is a bale of hay. Without breaking his rope, the horse is able to eat the hay whenever he chooses. How is this possible? Okay, a horse is tied to a 5-meter rope in front of an old saloon. 6 meters behind the horse is a bale of hay. Without breaking his rope, the horse is able to eat the hay whenever he chooses. How is this possible? A horse is tied to a 5-meter rope. Front of an old saloon. Six meters behind the horse is a bale of hay. I don't know how long a meter is. Okay, so a meter is a little over a yard. And a yard is, 3 feet? So, I mean, if he depends on where he's tied. Because, I mean, if he's tied, like, on his saddle, then he just turns around. You know how long a freaking horse is? If it's tied to his foot or something? I don't know. The rope is not tied to anything else. That was so stupid. Because the rope is not tied to... Then what was the point of having a rope on the horse? If you're not going to tie it to anything. That's. I'm always in charge. I'm never in debt. I'm known as the first amongst all my kind. I'm found within cars, but never in buses. I'm not using Mexico. I'm using Palestine. What am I? Wait, what? It's the letter A. because it's always in charge, not in debt, found in cars, not in buses, not used in Mexico, but it's used in Palestine, and it's the first among its kind. It's first of the alphabet, so it's A. A. So that's 3 out of 4. I'm doing good. You know what? I'm not even going to get excited because last time I had like 5 out of 7 or something, and then I still ended with 50%, so all right. Yeah, I got 3 out of 4. Yay. What common English verb becomes its own past tense by rearranging its letters? I don't remember what verbs are. What common English verb becomes its own past tense by rearranging its letters? Is this like a helping verb? I don't even know. I don't remember any of that. I bet your firefighter wouldn't remember it either, even though he just graduated. Answer is eat and ate. I would have never guessed that. Man, I was thinking up the helping verbs. Has, have, had, did, do, does, did. What is it? I just said did twice. Anyway, those are not helping verbs. Those are linking. Wait, what are those? Those are, let me see. I forgot what it was. I was right. They're helping verbs. Hey, I remember. I retained something. All right. Next question. Even though I got that one wrong, I'm happy that I retained something. What is in seasons, seconds, centuries, and minutes, but not in decades, years, or days? Okay, so I got to look at the words again. Let's see. Seasons. Seasons. The letter N. N. The letter N. Yep. Okay, so I'm getting like the word ones right, pretty much, except for that eat and ate. But I got 4 out of 6 so far. That's not doing bad, but I was doing better last time, I think. I am 4 letters long. I can be seen in the sky. I am the ocean and I am the sea. Can you guess me? I am 4 letters long. I can be seen in the sky. I am the ocean and I am the sea. Blue. I think it's blue. Let's go with blue. Color blue. Yep. All right. 5 out of 7. Still not getting happy because I was 5 out of 7 last time and I messed up all 3. What's as big as you are yet doesn't weigh an ounce? What's as big as you are yet doesn't weigh an ounce? A crackhead. No, I'm not going to put that in. I'm going to leave that out. That was bad. What's as big as you are yet doesn't weigh an ounce? Air? Does air weigh anything? I don't know. A shadow. I should have guessed that. That's actually common sense. All of these are common sense, but that's common sense. A shadow. Yep. That fits the criteria. That's right. Man. Can't believe I didn't guess that. Trains travel from one... Let's try talking again, shall we? Trains travel from one town to another town all day. Always on the same track. Always going nonstop and at the same speed. The noon train took 80 minutes to complete the trip, but the 4 p.m. train took an hour and 20 minutes. Why? They're the same. 80 minutes and an hour and 20 minutes is the same because it's 60 plus 20. Because it takes an hour and 20 minutes to do it. That's why. Yeah, it's the same as that. Okay, cool. All right, so I got 6 out of 9. Hey, did better than last time. I'm happy on that one. But we still got one more, and I can possibly get 7 out of 10. So let's see what we got. A man went on a trip with a fox, a goose, and a sack of corn. He came upon a stream which he had to cross and found a tiny boat to use to cross the stream. He could only take himself and one other, the fox, the goose, or the corn at a time. He could not leave the fox alone with the goose or the goose alone with the corn. How does he get all safely over the stream? Trying to picture this in my mind and I can't figure it out. Okay, a man went on a trip with a fox, a goose, and a sack of corn. He came upon a stream which he had to cross and found a tiny boat to use to cross the stream. He could only take himself and one other, the fox, the goose, or the corn at a time. He could not leave the fox alone with the goose or the goose alone with the corn. How does he get them all safely over the stream? Because even if you take the goose over first, the goose will be over on the other side. But then you have to take the corn and the fox over next, the corn or the fox over. If you take the fox over, then they're still by themselves. If you take the corn over, then the corn's there with the goose. And you can't send the fox and the corn over at the same time by themselves because you got to take one of them with you because you got to be able to get it back. Well, I got a 6 out of 10, guys, because I don't know the answer to this one. What's the answer? Oh, my gosh. Wow, that's smart. Take the goose over first and come back. Then take the fox over and bring the goose back. Now take the corn over and come back alone to get the goose. Take the goose over and the job is done. That. That's pretty good. Hey, that's what you expect when you're looking at brain teasers. That is, wow. I would have never guessed that, but that is an amazing, amazing brain teaser. I like that. I should have taken longer on that to try to figure that out, but literally my mind was steady like, okay, I can't do that. Nope, can't do that. Nope, can't do that. Nope, can't do that. Okay, there's no way to do it, but wow. Good job, you guys. That was, if you got that one right, you got a good brain. You got some critical problem-solving skills. You need to make sure you're doing something with those because that's pretty good. Well, anyway, guys, that is all that I have for today for this video. Please like and subscribe to this page. I thank you guys so much immensely for all of the support you guys are giving me. I hope you guys like this. I hope that you guys want to see more of them because I'm going to be putting out more of them. So, hope you want to see him. But yeah, till we meet again. Thank you guys. I love you guys. Peace.